Now we'll see about electrical forced oscillator. The electrical forced oscillator is basically a circuit having LCR in series and connected with AC source. Okay. So here in comparison with mechanical forced oscillator, there a periodic force is applied on the particle. When steady state condition is obtained, it vibrates with the So when steady state condition is obtained, it vibrates with the applied force frequency. That is the case of mechanical forced oscillator or driven oscillator. Whereas, in case if you compare with these electrical forced oscillator, the AC source that we are applying into in the circuit, okay, it is driving force. That is the external force that is applied in the circuit. Okay, so we'll see that in a circuit, an inductor and a capacitor and a resistor is connected to a AC source. Okay, so here the AC source is E naught sin omega t, and this is inductor of inductance L, capacitor of capacitance C, and resistor resistance R. Across it, the back EMF VL, and the voltage across capacitor is VC, across resistor is VR. So let us write that the voltage across or back EMF, whatever, voltage across inductor of inductance L is VL, L into di by dt. Let I is the current at any time that is flowing in the circuit. Similarly, voltage across capacitor of capacitance C, say VC is equal to Q by C. Similarly, the voltage across resistor of resistance R, VR is equal to IR. So, these are the potential differences across those elements connected in the circuit. Now we will apply the Kirchhoff rule. According to Kirchhoff voltage law, okay, so L into di by dt plus I into R plus Q by C is equal to how much? E naught sin omega t. Let us differentiate this equation with respect to time. Then differentiating above equation with respect to time, then we get L into d square I by dt square plus R into di by dt plus dq by dt is I by c is equal to E naught omega cos omega t. Differentiation of sin is cos omega t, internal differentiation omega. So, E naught omega cos omega t, that is the equation we get. Okay, so This is the basic equation, second order differential equation, and let us assume some solution for this. Okay, let solution be okay. So that is the equation. Let us give equation 1. The solution of equation I is equal to I naught, it is a possible solution. I into I naught sin omega t minus phi. Now we will differentiate this with respect to time di by dt, we get I naught omega cos omega t minus phi. And d square I by dt square also will do. This is minus I naught omega square, cos differentiation is minus sin, internal differentiation omega, already omega is there, so omega square sin omega t minus phi. Now we will substitute these equation 2, 3, 4 in 1, substituting 2, 3, 4 equations in equation 1. L into d square I by dt square is, so minus L into I naught omega square sin omega t minus phi plus R into di by dt, R into I naught omega cos omega t minus phi plus I by C. So, I naught by C sin omega t minus phi is equal to this one, E naught omega, E naught omega cos omega t. See here, see the LHS of the equation, the angle is omega t minus phi. For mathematical easiness, here also we will write in the same manner. This is omega t minus phi, will add it phi. We are adding phi and subtracting, then E naught cos omega t only we get. Okay. So now let us expand this cos A plus cos A plus B, cos A cos B minus sin A sin B. This LHS I am writing over here minus, if I take sin omega t common, I naught simply sin omega t here in this equation, sin omega t if I take common minus L I naught omega square plus I naught by C sin omega t minus phi, sin omega t minus phi is taken common here minus L I naught omega square plus I naught by C plus R I naught omega cos omega t minus phi is equal to, let us expand this one. If you expand this one, E naught omega cos A plus B is cos A cos B. So, cos omega t minus phi plus into cos B cos phi minus A naught omega sin A sin B sin omega t minus phi into sin B. So, here you just compare the coefficients of sin omega t minus phi and sin omega t minus phi. First, we will write those minus L I naught omega square plus I naught by C is equal to how much? This is minus E naught omega sin phi. Okay, this is equation 6. Similarly, let us equate coefficients of cos omega t minus phi. So what is the quotient there? R I naught omega is equal to how much here? E naught omega cos phi. Now we'll square equation 6 separately and square equation 7, then add. Squaring equation 6 and equation 7 and adding them, by adding them we get, see here, if you square it, E naught square omega square, this is also, we are squaring it, E naught square omega square sin square phi, E naught square omega square cos square phi. When you add it, you can take E naught square omega square common, then sin square phi plus cos square phi becomes 1. Is equal to here we'll add minus L I naught omega square plus I naught by C square plus R square I naught square omega square. So here this is 1 by C minus L omega square plus R square omega square. I have taken I naught square common. If you take I naught common over here, it becomes I naught square and it is 1 by C. This is minus, minus is there, L omega square plus R square omega square. So, from this equation, we will write what is I naught square. So, what is I naught square here? Square will write afterwards. I naught square is equal to E naught square. I am removing this square also, then root it becomes. I naught square is E naught square omega square. I naught is E naught omega whole divided by root of 1 by C minus L omega square. This is square, we have square plus R square omega square. In this equation, we will take minus omega common, minus omega. So, square will come. Okay. See here, I will write I naught is equal to E naught omega. If you take minus omega common, this becomes 1 by, this becomes omega L, because minus omega if taken common, here it becomes plus, here it becomes minus, minus 1 by omega C square plus R square. This is totally I am taking omega square common whole root. Just see once, throughout I am taking omega common, omega square. If one omega, because it is square is there, one omega if I take common becomes omega square. Omega square is 1 by omega C minus omega L, and minus also I am taking common, it becomes plus here. Omega L minus 1 by omega C, that we get. So, when you write out of the root, this becomes I naught is equal to E naught divided by omega square. If you take out the root, omega it becomes, omega omega get cancelled. So, here omega L minus 1 by omega C square plus R square. This is I naught, maximum current, or in terms of wave equation, it is amplitude, that is maximum current. Now, we will see what is phi angle, phi, just take the ratio of these two, taking ratio of two equations 6 and 7, then E naught omega get cancelled, minus tan phi is equal to, here take the ratio, then minus I naught, if you take ratio, I naught also get cancelled, minus L omega square plus 1 by C by R omega, and minus if you apply, it becomes omega L, okay, minus 1 by omega C. This minus I'm applying over here, omega L minus 1 by omega C, omega is also taken common, divided by R. See, if I take omega common over here, minus omega, omega L minus 1 by omega C divided by R omega, omega omega get cancelled, we get only R. So, this is tan phi. So, phi equal to how much? Tan inverse of omega L minus 1 by omega C by R. Okay. So, we got I naught, we got phi. What is the possible solution that we have taken? Equation to this is I equal to I naught sin omega t minus phi. These values we can substitute over there. See the equation, this equation if you see omega L minus 1 by omega C, depending on the values of L and C, omega L and omega C, the how the current is, whether it lag behind voltage applied EMF or it lag, it advances, those things we can discuss. So, this is the current I naught, E naught by root of omega L minus 1 by omega C whole square plus R square. So, in this equation, the very important parameter is so denominator value Z is equal to omega L minus 1 by omega C whole square plus R square. This is called impedance. Impedance, the effective, you can call the effective resistance offered in the circuit by these inductors, capacitors, those things. And this omega L is, we can represent as XL, 1 by omega C as XC, and R is resistance, right. So, this is 1 by omega C, this is 1 by omega L. So, this is Z is called impedance. Now, case 1 if you consider, if omega L is less than 1 by omega C, one case. Second case, if omega L is equal to 1 by omega C. Third one is, if omega L is greater than 1 by omega C. In these three cases, the current and the applied EMF, the relation we can give. See, in this case, the current apply current in the circuit and applied EMF is E, applied EMF, both are in phase. Okay. So, in this case, both are in phase. In this case, omega L greater than omega C, see the equation, if omega L is greater than 1 by omega C, phi will be positive. See here in this equation, this is positive. So, here current lags behind applied EMF. So, I lags behind applied EMF. So, in this case, the case when omega L is less than 1 by omega C, phi is negative. In this case, what happens? Applied EMF lags behind current. Okay. So, these are the three cases in this forced electrical forced oscillator. Power generated in the circuit, we will see. What is the applied voltage? E is equal to E naught sin omega t. Instantaneous voltage applied in the circuit, AC source. What is the instantaneous current? We know I naught sin omega t minus phi. So, instantaneous power Pi is E into I. So, this is E naught I naught sin omega t into sin omega t minus phi. So, average power P bar or P average is equal to how much? Integral in one cycle period, the value right? And how much total time in a given, or the instantaneous time, the integral of its time, total time, integral 0 to t dt is the total time, that is time taken in one cycle. Let us substitute this here, then p average is equal to, this is 1 by t, I can write integral 0 to t, this integral 0 to t dt is the 1 by t, e naught I naught sin omega t sin omega t minus phi. So, here it is omega t is A, omega t minus phi is B, and it is sin A sin B form. Cos A minus B, cos A minus B, that is cos A cos B plus sin A sin B minus cos A plus B. Cos A cos B minus, that is minus minus becomes plus, cos A cos B get cancelled. So, cos A cos A minus B minus cos A plus B will take. So, P average is equal to 1 by T naught integral 0 to T, here E naught I naught we can write. So, cos A minus B, cos A is omega T minus omega t plus phi cos A minus B into cos minus minus cos A plus B omega t plus omega t minus phi dt. So, P average is equal to E naught I naught by T naught T, T naught is not required, T integral 0 to T cos phi minus cos 2 omega T, because omega T cancels over here, cos phi minus cos 2 omega T minus phi into D. So, if you do the integration, this term will become 0, integral of cos 2 omega t minus phi dt becomes 0, and this is cos phi integral 0 to t dt, that is t. So, this is, we get E naught I naught by t cos phi into t. From here we got E naught I naught cos phi. Okay, so here when you apply this one, this becomes 2 sin A sin B, right? 2 sin A sin B it becomes. So, divided by 2. This is again we can write as E naught by root 2 into I naught by root 2 cos phi, and P average is equal to E naught by root 2 is E RMS. I naught by root 2 is I RMS into cos phi. This is the average power developed in the electrical forced oscillator. That is when it is connected in, when a LC or combination is connected to AC source, this is the power generated, average power generated, right. So, if you have any doubts, you can write in comment section, those doubts will be clarified. We will try to answer it, and like it, share the video and spread among your friends.